Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, today we will discuss about the transformer coupled class A power amplifier, its circuit diagram and working. This is the diagram of transformer coupled class A power amplifier. Now this is also termed as single ended transformer coupled power amplifier, because we are using the single transistor, so it is termed as single ended power amplifier. Now what is the reason why we use transformer coupled class A power amplifier? In case of single stage class A power amplifier, the transistor is directly coupled to the load, and because of that the current flowing through the load resistance, so that is given as ICQ square into RL. So this is the amount of power which is wasted across the load resistor. To avoid that, we are using the transformer where these windings are having less resistance, and because of that there is less wastage of the power. So here the load resistance is connected through transformer coupling to the transistor. We are using the transistor as a power transistor. First we will discuss about the circuit diagram. We are using R1, R2 and RE, which is voltage divider biasing, and voltage divider biasing is necessary to keep the Q point exactly at the center of the load line, and because of that this transistor will work as an amplifier. Capacitor C1, which is known as a coupling capacitor, which couples the input to the base of the transistor. We are applying the input in terms of volts. Then we are using the transformer having the turns ratio N1 and N2, which is directly coupled to the load resistance. Here the impedance matching property can be explained as V1 is equal to N1 upon N2 into V2 by the transformer action. Similarly, when we consider current, it is I1 is equal to N2 divided by N1 into I2. Because of the impedance matching, we match the impedance, that is low impedance of the load resistor, with the impedance of the amplifier. So we will take the ratio. So this ratio is V1 upon I1 is equal to N1 upon N2 the whole square into V2 divided by I2. Now V2 divided by I2 is basically the load resistance. This is the turns of ratio, that is N1 upon N2 the whole square, and V1 upon I1 is the primary winding resistance, which we can denote it as a RL dash. So to match the impedance of the primary winding and the secondary winding, the value of N1 and N2 should be properly adjusted, so that RL dash is equal to N1 upon N2 the whole square into RL. So this is the impedance matching in case of transformer coupled class A power amplifier. Whatever output is available across the primary winding of transformer is coupled to the secondary winding, and since the impedance is properly matched, that is RL dash and RL, we adjust the turns of ratio and these two impedances becomes equal, so that the maximum power will transfer from transformer winding to the load resistance. Then we will write down the AC load line variations. It is the graph of VCE and IC. This is the AC load line. And Q point is exactly at the center of the load line. Here, the maximum voltage is equal to the VCC voltage. The voltage corresponding to Q point is VCEQ, and the current corresponding to IC is ICQ. The voltage will vary from VCEQ to 0 and from 0 to VCC. Similarly, current ICQ will vary from ICQ point to the maximum value up to 0 at the minimum side, that is in the cutoff region. So these are the AC load variations in case of transformer coupled single ended class A power amplifier. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda.